Oh my god, dude. Ridiculous. I knew that was gonna happen. I knew it was gonna happen. Okay, hopefully it's back. I knew the second that I knew the second that my on-screen keyboard froze that my keyboard was doomed. Wow, looks like I'm not the only one. I told you that my streams get effed. Okay, are we good now? We chilling or what? I'm gonna give it a little bit of time for some for the let's get some water. You guys are actually gonna be proud of me because I've been starting to buy my water by the jug, these glass jugs. That way I save on some plastic. So we're gonna do a little fill up here while we wait for people to come back. Oof. Don't spill. Ice. Wait, you don't drink straight from that jug? No, I don't. That would be an arm workout within itself, huh? So it's actually kind of cool. This place near me, they sell this water, and then you actually just bring this glass jug back in and they fill it up. Kind of cool. Two shots of vodka. Yo. Ryan saves up his teardrops to drink later. Oh, you fancy, huh? Hair done, nair done, everything did. I know someone who worked there. Did you really? Dude, that place is legit. Doing it over the ogre? Yo, at least I didn't pull out Tim Kunis. Man, damn it. This stream's gonna be freaking cut in half again, just like the other one. Man, Twitch hates me, bro. Maybe it's the rain. I don't know. If you drank from that jug, would you drink it through the side of your mouth? 100%. That's the only. Dude, freaking Sandy was making fun of me like that too, because I was drinking from the side. I don't know why. Is that not normal? Do you guys don't drink like this? Oh, you drink like this? That's weird. I feel like when I drink like head on, it's gonna go up my nose or something. Get the Korean water filter, dude. Okay, Huru, you gotta help me out. My roommate used to do that because he always had a headset. Maybe I'm just used to having a headset on. What keycaps are those? This is GMK Oblivion Mono. Drink with two hands like a normal person? Who what? Like a baby bottle? Hey, yo, this dude changed his outfit. Dude, I took off my jacket. It was a little toasty in here. That sent normal. Okay, I'm gonna assume that meant that is normal. Okay, anyway. Let's take a look here. Thank you for the follow. You know, I thought my Twitch woes were over. Do you know what the Bari Sax is? I don't. What's the Bari Sax? Is that hopefully you're not setting me up. I'm generally surprised that you didn't spill when you drink sideways. I don't know. I'm glad that you're surprised. Hopefully that means you're impressed. All right, man, get on with it. Whoa, dude. I'm not falling for that, Hochella. You drink slower when using the other side of your mouth? I don't use the other side. All right. Pretty much the same board, right? Now that we are back in business. They would love you if you streamed more consistently. Wow, are you telling me I don't stream consistently? Do I not stream enough? Should I stream more? I don't know, dude. I stream like, what, 3 times a week? The Ogre 65. Did you finish the bag gummy worms? I did not. All right, so we have the NK65 Entry Edition. This red is actually suit. Look at that, dude. That's pretty sick. You stream a good amount, IMO. Nice, thank you. See, John? You stream twice a week, if you even. Wow. This red is actually super nice. We used to do 3 times a week before. Okay, well, you know, I've been busy, all right? So we got inks on this bad boy. Let's get these caps on. Yo, Milk Pumba, thank you for the follow. All right. So we're gonna be using EPBT Retro Cyrillic. Busy indeed with the other Korean teacher.
Pretty much.
Can you blame me, Huru? Oh, that's not supposed to go there. Yo! What? This is actually gonna sound pretty good. Wow! That completely eliminated the rattle. Listen to this. This backspace actually sounds good. I'm not even lying. You mean to tell me you have a life outside of streaming Keebs? How dare you? I'm very sorry, Sniffles. I'll get less of a life. Hey, I say I'm gonna start streaming again, and then I stream once and don't stream for months, so doing better than me. Thank you. I appreciate that. Search up baritone sax and it will come up. This is one of the sax that I play. Okay, I'll check that out. Dude, I wish I knew how to play the sax. All I know how to play is the recorder. Hedge wondering why his NK65 doesn't sound like this. Wow. It's the magic of silicon, exactly. What's up, cub beggar? I don't blame you. A man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. Huru, you know what I'm talking about. How does the BDZ loop compare to dielectric? So the BDZ is actually, I would say it's thicker even than dielectric. The problem with dielectric is it's thick. It does a good job of insulating the wire, but it moves around. It's too viscous, right? So after time, it starts to kind of pile up in certain areas, whereas this lube here, super thick, but I feel like it stays exactly where you put it. Anno mismatch? Def not. Honestly, the watermelon one is straight fire, dude. I wish Novel Keys or someone had a board like this when I first got into the hobby. So far this board has been a pleasure. And I bought this with my own money, so you can tell I did not get a discount, so I'm not BSing you guys. Dude, this is actually gonna sound good, I think. And plays recorder from the side of his mouth. Bro, don't make me get my recorder. I will burst all your eardrums. Would have no issues with CoStar. That's true. Honestly, this doesn't... These stabs are fine. I kind of want to put... Nah, it'll sound better probably with PBT, I think, on this board. But we are forced to do normal caps, which is a little bit sad. A little bit sad. Can you back up your claim you can play the recorder? Oh, I sure can. I'll grab it in 1 second. Wait, weren't you supposed to record sub sounds with the recorder? Dude, I was supposed to do a lot of things. I haven't even uploaded any videos to YouTube. I'm very sorry. Very sorry. It's probably a good thing considering I do so much embarrassing shit. We got arrows on this, right? No anno mismatch. Definitely no anno mismatch on this bad boy. Bring it. No stepped caps. Yeah, that's probably my only gripe so far, that I don't have a stepped caps, which kind of sucks. It would be funny if the NK65 became your daily... Dude, honestly? Okay, Honestly, you guys are gonna freak out when I start, when I do the typing test. I'm not even kidding. What the hell? How does this sound so good? I think it's a combination of using inks with PBT caps that are probably helping out. But I would like to give the board quite a bit of credit as well. Play My Heart Goes On with... Okay, that's a little bit giving me too much credit, Huru. Come on. We all know I can't do that. Play a song on the recorder channel point reward. Bro, I'm scared that coaster will get ruined by the drink. I know. Ah! Where are you gonna rest that left pinky when... Oh, right? Maybe I just won't put the caps on. He has to do the pose as well. Careless Whisper on the recorder? Dude! Okay, after I learn Korean and I am fluent, which, let's be honest here, Probably gonna be a couple months. I'm gonna learn Careless Whisper on the recorder. Oh. Dude, this looks badass. Dude, it really does. Honestly, I'm quite impressed right now. I can't believe this board was in stock when I bought it, too. Weren't people making, like, a huge stink about this board selling out and stuff? I wasn't even planning on buying this board. I was on Novel Keys. I was like, ah, let's see what they have in stock. And I saw this board was in stock, and it was the red that I like. So I'm like, all right, $95, what could go wrong? I'll make a stream out of it. And let's just say I'm, like, pleasantly surprised right now. It's been a lot of rounds. Oh, okay, so in the beginning it was a lot harder to get. Is that what you're saying? I think they come and go fast. Okay, so maybe I just found it at like the perfect timing. Dude, this board looks sick. The second round lasted almost an hour. It was just round one. The red I like. He probably even gonna buy burgundy colored toilet. Dude, if they made burgundy colored toilet paper, I totally would buy it. The only thing is that the tray mount is too stiff for me, but some of y'all prefer that. I honestly am okay with stiff. As long as it's not harsh, I'm okay with stiff. All right, let's see what else we got. The dreaded normal caps. They sold out in like 30 seconds back in August. Okay, that must have been what people were getting all fussy about. Which ones go here? Oh, so this is an interesting layout. The watermelon was up for a few days that I checked. Some of the black PCs still sold out. Okay, so the black one was super popular. Honestly, this watermelon was probably, this probably would have been my favorite choice, to be honest. So I kind of lucked out on that. How do we open this thing? Hello? Is this taped? Oh, outsmart the case, Ryan. Nathan Quang, thank you for the follow. Fire Red still in stock right now. It looks now. Fire Red, is that like the orange one, or is that the, that's the burnt orange fire one, right? The smoke didn't restock this time. I like your shirt. Yo, thank you. It's a Japanese cartoon that I used to watch. Does the silicone at the bottom help cushion out the stiffness a bit? I don't know. To be honest, I couldn't tell you if the silicone is there to cushion or if it's mainly for sound. I think it's mainly for sound because I think this is pretty much tray mount. I don't see the plate moving at all. So yeah, it's the orange one. Watermelon is gas, dude. It goes very well with gray. Yeah, to be honest, I was very tempted to put Oblivion Mono on this, but I thought it would sound better. I thought it would sound better with PBT caps. This is an interesting layout though. So you have like a win key or a 625 space bar. Wait, what is these? What are these? The 15 or 125s with the ones? Kind of interesting. All right, we're missing the shift. That would look super good. Agreed. All right, so what do we put in here? Let's see. All right, so we're gonna do, let's see, probably do delete up top. I kind of want to put the FN. We'll do code. We'll swap these. Ooh, you know what? I'm actually gonna put the lats on this. Yo, that's actually gonna look sick. Wow, that matches the PC perfect. Okay, page down. We'll do up here. There you go. Page up. Page down. And delete. And we're gonna put code here. Perfect. All right, we'll pop the ogre out of here. Wow, that would look super good. Damn, bro, you make everything so clean looking. Dude, don't give me too much credit. Just doubled in value. Where'd you get your desk shelf? So this is actually from Grovemade. It's a little bit pricey, but to be honest, totally worth it. It's like $200. I like it so much that I actually bought one for work as well. It works perfect because I'm able to put stuff on top for streaming. See how this goes under, right? And then I just have my cable pop out there. So I actually love this thing. Did you see Truly Made iced tea? Oof, I have not. Their lemonade's pretty freaking bomb though. I have returned just in time. What's up, Darian? Now over, yeah, bro, the lats are more expensive than the board. Go figure. That escape looks perfect. Yo, right? Take a look. Wow, dude, what? What? That's so perfect. Are you kidding me? Dude, this might be my new daily driver. Look at that. So sick. Wow. We'll get a load of the FN as well. Every time you throw your boards on the bed, I get flashbacks of what happened to Black Simon. I know, dude. At one point, I had like 10 boards on my bed, and it was even sketching me out a little bit. $50 for it, deal. Bro, the board's only $95. What sick, the escape or them biceps? Dude, don't even, bro. I've hit the gym like twice in the last like 6 months. I've probably been to the gym like 5 times in the last 6 months. It's pretty bad. They just reopened our gym and it's like an outdoor gym. It's kind of wonky, so I've been using that as my excuse not to go. What a match. A match made in heaven. Am I right, Huru? This board you can chuck for sure. Bro, right? This red is so sick, dude. It matches like perfect. Who needs the gym when you build keeps? Am I right? Right? The match is on point. Okay, cursed. Pretty sick, dude. All right. Enough of that. Check out the bottom. You can see that silicone pad in there still. We have a screwless design, a seamless design. Dude, I'm honestly even impressed by this USB port. Could that be any tighter? Look at that. Look inside there. Please, please, please look at that. Let me clean this a little bit there. Dude, that's pretty damn tight in there. That's pretty sick. It's toy, like a toyga. That's pretty dope. All right, enough of my marveling. How is she gonna type? So even the front height, to be honest, super nice. I would say this is probably, I don't even have to worry about dropping it either, huh? It's a little bit higher, maybe like 20, 19 and a half, 20 maybe. tight is Breaking Bad reference. Yo, that's pretty damn tight. Drop tested, passed. Way better than my Tina. Yo, right? I've suggested this board to friends that want to get into keebs. Yeah, 100%. Don't forget to put your points in for your predictions. Yo, John, you're like the best campaign manager I ever hired. I need that desk mat of yours. When can I get my hands on her? So this is the Gaff desk mat. It was ran, gosh, maybe a couple months ago at this point, maybe a month or two ago. And it's obviously, if you're familiar with Gaff, these are his sculpts for his artisans. So he made a desk mat out of them, or Shuang helped him. But it was ran a bit ago. I know it was like $50, even through the GB. So it was a little bit expensive. In my opinion, totally worth it, because the quality of this is super nice. I mean, you can see how clear it is. But from what I've seen on Mech Market, they're going for maybe like 70, $75. That shit's worth, man, $100. Is this going for $100 now? No way. Dude, check this out. This cable is actually going to be perfect. Wow. This build was meant to be, bro. Kind of cool. So this has the per switch RGB, right? So you can kind of see it underneath there. There you go. So it doesn't quite light up the bottom. You can see it kind of going through the silicone. Is that the watermelon? It is indeed. I saw one on Mech Market go for over 200. Dude, I should probably stop spilling on mine then, huh? I ordered the clear version, still waiting on switches and keycaps. Yo, Bruno, this is the board you end up getting, huh? Dude, I think you're going to be happy. Novel Key should have you market their NK65. right, bro? I just bought this with my own money because I wanted it. Is this a personal board? It is. This is a personal board. I bought this board, came in today. All right, let's take a look. Let's check out the stab, shall we? All right, so keep in mind, so these stabs are plate mount stabs, right? So they're not usually considered the best stabs. They're plate mount. They did come with a poop ton of dielectric grease. And even with that, they sounded absolutely miserable. So if you are buying this board and it is your first board, I would highly suggest lubing the stabs. It's not hard. I did it on stream. You can watch my before it cut out. I think it was on the first stream. It takes you maybe 15 minutes or if you're slow like me, maybe 20 minutes. So I think it's 100% worth it. Because after I lube them, they sound it's night and day. Absolutely night and day. Check this out. Okay, honestly, this backspace rivals a lot of high-end boards. This backspace is actually, like, proper. Like, if I close my eyes right now and I hit this, it could be a $1,000 board. Honestly, I couldn't tell. Spacebar is not amazing. Spacebar, I will say, is not amazing. This shift is pretty good. The enter's a little bit hollow, but this backspace is actually fire. Like, on a $95 board, are you kidding me? You joking my ass? Listen to this backspace. There's no tick at all. Pretty sick, dude. All right. A lot better than... Dude, it's literally night and day. Like, I would venture to say the stabs in stock form are borderline unusable. If you're coming from, like, a Corsair to that... You're not gonna care. But if you've used lube stabs ever in your life, you need to lube these stabs. Mine never sounded this good. Bro, you gotta get the BDZ. You gotta get this, bro. Honestly, like I should try building one of these with 205 grade zero on the stabs just to compare. But I'm telling you, this shit works wonders. It's gonna be on space cables next week, I think. Gonna use this to learn the way of the keyboard, yo. Nice. What makes a good space bar? Here, I'll show you a little comparison. What space bar sounds? I think the Dolphin sounds pretty good. All right, here you go. I won't even have to tell you what sounds good. You can hear it. I would venture to say that the backspace on the NK65 sounds better than the Dolphin. I feel like the XHT lube easily splatters on the stem of the stabs, then makes them feel mushy. You gotta be super careful with them. When you're putting it in. Same thing with dielectric grease. That's why I never liked using dielectric grease, because if you get it on the stems at all, it makes them mushy. So in reality, you really have to just pay attention when you're putting the wire into the housing. As long as you're super careful and don't get it on the stem, you're fine. Coming to space cable soon, yes. So lube makes that big of a difference, 100%, 100%. If you guys listen to me test out the stabs before I lube them, it's night and day. Let me see what Lil Stax is doing. We're building an NK65. I haven't been this excited to build a board in a while. So let's type it. Let's type on this thing. The Dolphin sounds better, IMO. Yeah, you know what? Let me hear it again. It does. Here, this one sounds pretty good too. We can compare it to the KFE. All right, not the KFE, sorry, the K. Yeah, so the actual PBT versus ABS will make a little bit of a difference as well. One more time? Are you serious, bro? Here, I'll compare it to Heine's board. He's joking? Are you joking? Are you joking my ass? Are you? Dude, see? I'm just trying to be a nice guy, and you're trolling me. Wow. Literally, if you would have asked me like five more times, one more time, I probably would have done it. That's the last time I let my guard down. Alright, so you guys can't really see it from my angle. But, yeah, hope you feel bad now. So you can't really see it from the top-down angle, but from my angle sitting here, it looks like this. So you can actually see the RGB underneath, which is kind of cool. All right, final decision time. Let's do a typing test. Does keycap material make a difference? Also, shake my head. Too many variables. It does. So generally speaking, personal preference, or rather opinion, I have found that PBT keycaps are a little bit bassier, a little bit kind of creamier, fuller, whereas GMKs can be a little bit higher pitched. There is quite a big difference. I wouldn't say one is better than the other. I've had some boards like, for instance, my Matrix 2.0. I actually prefer GMK versus PBT, whereas on my RS, I actually prefer PBT versus ABS. So it kind of, for me personally, it depends on the board. 60 seconds whenever you're ready. Okay. What keycaps are those? These are the EPBT Retro Cyrillic. They were on Originative for quite a bit. GMK be like tack tack, PBT be like tuck tuck. Pretty much. PBT mod warping is just so bad. It really is. I mean, you can almost see a little bit of warping on this space bar as well. These mods are pretty solid though. Just got my second set of GMK today. In my opinion, GMK is the best, solid, and most sturdy. Yeah, so GMK generally is known for having more vibrant colors as well. Because of the, usually ABS, you can have double shot or even triple shot. Whereas PBT is normally die sub. So it can be a little bit fuzzier. You can not get as vibrant of colors like GMK. But additionally, ABS can shine a lot quicker. PBT does shine. It does shine, but it takes a long time to shine. OG die subs are the GOAT. Agreed. I have OG die subs on the RS, and I don't know if those will ever leave. That's what I love about mechanical keyboards, though. There are literally so many variables. It's so hard to have an identical board as someone else. Gotta love the ABS GMK. Yeah, I do have... What board? All right, I'm looking up your baritone sax. Let's see that thing. Oh yeah, that's the legit one, dude. That one's the one that you can jam to. That's the official one. Like on the 2.0, I like GMK over PBT. Yeah, so Tekken, that's exactly what I just said. I like the GMK over PBT on the 2.0 as well. No, you shine, Mr. Streamer. Shine bright like a diamond. All right, one day I'll be able to pick up GMK Originative Japanese. Dude, right? That set pops. K-Thrizzy has that, and I really want it. All right, I think it's time to do a typing test. Oh, wait, no, it didn't change. I still don't have the same one that Huru told me to get. One day L9 beige space bars will restock at OCO. Ooh. They had them for a bit, I want to say. Christian server, I know, I'm sorry. Okay, here we go. 60 seconds on the clock. Wait, I should probably make sure that all the... I mean, I didn't have to solder anything, but we could still have bent pins. So let me double check real quick so I don't throw off people's predictions. Oh, that one's not. That one must have a bent pin. Solid. All right, so we got one bent pin, or it could be a faulty switch, one of the two. So it's this one right here. Where is my There it is. All right, so let's take a look. Yo, the inks are actually gonna look sick with this, with the backlight LED. All right, so as suspected, we do have a bent pin. Oh my goodness, right there. So we're gonna swap that one out. Put a new one in. And we're good. Easy, easy mode. All right. Can I get Discord permissions later so I can upload emotes to the server? 100%. That Switch puller is goated, been through two Rama and not, dude, right? This is honestly the best one. This is the best one. It the only issue is that when you're doing it, it does kind of dig into your finger right here. If you're doing like a full TKL at the end of it, you got this huge dent right here. That's the only bad thing. Hot swap Kryzen solder. Yo, how often are y'all pulling out switches? I desolder boards like a madman, so way too much. Okay, here we go. You guys ready for this? So we got NK65 Entry Edition, Gateron Inks, V1 205 Grade Zero, TX Films, Sprit 62 gram springs, aluminum plate, silicon dampener in there, EPBT Retro Cyrillic keycaps. And I think that's it. Here we go. Damn, dude, this for $95, are you joking my ass? The only thing I complain about is the space bar. It's a little bit higher pitched than I would expect, or sorry, not even that I would expect. This is what I would expect for a $95 board. You were going so fast. Wow, I went under. What was the over under? Was it 125? Oh wait, I won points. Oh, always 125. Damn, 123. That's a rip. I hate you, Ryan. Wow, dude, that's a little bit rough. Damn, bro, I thought you got it. Prediction results. How'd you guys do? $68,000 are going to Cornographic and 20 others. Wow. Yikes. I believed in you. Dude, I tried. Come on. I thought I was cruising there for a bit. I did have one big dip. Maybe that dip is what hurt me, huh? Cheap boards that are usable are super dope. Dude, right? All right, let's take one more. I'm going to do another test here. I'll do a 30-seconder for you guys. Dude, sounds pretty damn good, to be honest. That's actually pretty impressive. Pretty damn impressive. I like to compare this to the Kara, the Rama Kara. That'd be a good comparison. But I think at the end of the day, if I had a friend come to me that was like, I want the cheapest usable board I can get, I would have no qualms recommending this board, for sure. Really, really nice board. I think the only board that I would get from that I would personally recommend to a friend as an upgrade from this board would probably be like a Brutal or a Savage. But I probably wouldn't even mess with any other boards in between the two. Easiest 2,000 points in my life. Wow. We're not doubters, just realists. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, other than the space bar, it's pretty solid. This gets more points for it being available fairly often. Exactly. 100%. Okay, let's take one last look at this, and then I'll do my freaking leaf typing test. Here we are. Okay. Pretty damn sick, dude. I'm pretty happy with this board. And like I said, I'm not sponsored by Novel Keys. I didn't get a discount or anything on this board. I legitimately just went to the website, bought it with my own monies. And thought I'd give you guys an honest review. And yeah, I think this gets my stamp of approval. You guys have seen me review boards in the past. I'm pretty fair and pretty honest. And for $95, if you're upset with this board for $95, you have way too high of expectations. Because I cannot see anyone buying this and not being happy with it for the price, for sure. I think even if this board was like $150, I probably would still recommend it, given that it comes with the PCB and plate. So, pretty cool. I might just keep this built up to give to friends to get them to a little taste of mechanical keyboards. This might be actually the this might be the first board I ever built without actually taking it apart. That's kind of crazy. How much do you want for it? I could use another. Just buy it. They're still. I think the orange ones are still in stock for $95. It punched above its weight class for sure. 100%. 100%. When you're trying to make your friends broke, yeah, bro. This is like the gateway drug. Be like, here, try this out. It's only $95. I'm sure you'll be happy with it. They're happy with it for like 3 months and then they're like four keyboards deep. I would say this is definitely the gateway drug keyboard. Even has a starry sky pattern. Yeah, so it kind of has, it almost looks like they're stars, right? But those are actually the standoffs, I believe, right? My gateway drug was the Tofu 60, that'll do it. I think the watermelon turned out fantastic. I mean, I've said it already. This red is really cool. I'm actually happy that it's not like a lighter red. What was your first custom board? Oof. My first full aluminum board, I think, was a Camp C225 TKL. Yep. That's an old board. Photography is definitely a yikes, dude. I had to buy, I was using a Razer cam forever. And then I finally upgraded to an A6400. Is that what I have? Yeah, A6400. Shit's pricey, bro. Oh, let's weigh it for you guys. So if you guys were trying to go like super, super budget board, I'm using inks in these right now, which are like, what, 70, are they like 70, 80 cents a switch? You could even go with these, which are the KS3s. by Gateron. These are like 20, 25 cents a Switch. Absolutely absurdly cheap. And they, I would say they're like pretty damn good. I don't think you'll be mad that you got these. They're not quite as good as Inks sound wise. But if you're going super budget board, I would pick up the NK65, $95. 65 of these Switches, so 70 of these Switches will run you like what? Like 30, 20 something bucks? 30 bucks? No, even less, like 20 something bucks. And then I would pick up the Key Creative blanks on Key Company, which is another 25 bucks. So you pretty much have an entire built board for, what is that, 150 bucks? I don't see any reason why you'd be mad about that. All right, let's weigh it. So a pound, 14 ounces, or 862 gram. So if you wanted to compare that to the Leaf, oh my God, it's out in Narnia. Wow, it's actually heavier than the Leaf. What? Damn, that's kind of crazy. The weight, the Leaf even has a black aluminum weight too. 826. 858. So there you go. Yeah, that silicone weight must be pretty, holy shit, dude. What? Is it really that thick? Is it this whole thing? Is this entire chunk silicone? Wow, that is super thick. What the? I did not know it was that thick. That's crazy. Oh, there you go. You can see it right there. So it's that wedge. That's kind of crazy. Do you live in San Fran? I do live in California, but not NorCal. I'm in SoCal. I took mine apart. I might have to take this apart just for science at one point. Okay, we'll do the Leaf test, and then I think we will be on our way. Give me one second here. I'm gonna go to the little boys' room. All right, we're back. No, oh, what music is this? All right. John, I think we are ready, correct? Let's do a typing test. How was your dump? Come on, dude. I wish I could poop that fast. All right, here we go. 60 seconds on the clock. Did you use the Burgundy TP? Bro, I'm going to go search for Burgundy TP right after this. Okay, so this is the Leaf with 300 gram springs. And we're ready to roll. I got to put on some hardcore music for this one. Okay, here we go. Oh wait, shit, we got 1 minute, we gotta go 1 minute. Okay. I saw it, don't worry. My hand is cramping. Oh my god, dude. My hand was actually cramping. I think it's too cold in here. Shit. Oh man, that was so bad. What was the over-under on that one? 90, bro, come on. Look how much my forearm pumped on that, bro. No way I could hit 90, come on. Second believer gang murder tonight. The music in the background made it so much funnier. Okay, get this board out of here. Ah, a normal board. That completely threw off my white balance. There we go. Thought you were going for the Black Simon Yeet? Dude, I should have at that point. All right, shall we see who's streaming tonight? Spain without the S. Oh wait, I was gonna do a giveaway. You're right. What do we got here? How many are in here? Marbles? I don't have the marbles yet. Shit. I'm sorry. Let's count how many we got. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44. 46, 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58, 62, 4, 6, 8, 72, 4, 6, 8, damn, 82, 4, 6, 90. All right, we got 90 novel keys. I think these are sick. I'm gonna do the espresso. We went a little bit overboard. It's already 10 o'clock. I'm gonna do the espresso martini next time. Oh, drink water. Maze migration, you're still here? You're crazy. There's no way I can have an espresso martini at 10 o'clock. Are you kidding me? I'm not gonna be able to sleep. I like how you pick out certain switches to count even though they're all the same. Pretty much. Is your machine a decent? It is, a decent DE1. Oh my god, dude. My hand was actually cramping on that typing test. All right. So we're doing 70 novel keys. I think these are silks, right? And then we're doing, 90. And then we're doing two packs of TX 60 gram springs. How do I enter? That is a great question. Let me pull this up here. Yes, these are regular springs, not the long ones. All right, we're doing Kaze is lit. There you go. That is the key word. Hey, Grace, I hope you win some switches and some springs, but don't have a keyboard. It's free real estate. I have made a mess in my room. It's all your guys' fault. I wish I had a keyboard. I wish I had keyboard. No follower mode? Oh well, it's fine. It's fine. If you're watching, you're supporting. We don't need follower mode for this one. Oh, by the way, this is, as all giveaways, this is, I will pay for the shipping, but you need to be in the US, okay? That's the only qualifier. Please explain the free real estate every time you drink something. It actually says free real estate every time I get a follow. What do you mean? Is that just coincidence? Every time I grab my drink, it automatically does free real estate. That'd be pretty sick. All right, we'll give it another 15, maybe 30 seconds here. I'm so stoked on these coasters. I like don't even want to use them. They're so nice. No marbles yet. No marbles yet. All right, US only. Remember. All right. I think it's time. Roll it. Justin HPKB, do you claim your prize? The 90 silks and the 260 grams. Poggies. He doesn't, but I do. Do you claim your prize? The suspense is killing me. Hello? Hello? Are you there? Hi. I am here. Do you claim your prize? Do you claim? Claim. Oh my god. All right. We have a winner, winner, chicken dinner. Poggies. All righty, sir. These are all you. Congrats. Congratulations. Just PM and yes, please hit up John, who will help facilitate the giveaway. He's from Asia. I know him. Wow. Damn. All right, I'm going to be making the espresso martini on the next stream because there's no way I can have a double shot right now. Let's see if we can find someone to raid. I swear it's a good one, though. It's time for the Abu Raya giveaway. Oh, my God. Thank you, team. Dude, thank you, bro. Thank you for subbing. Damn, bro. We got a lot of people streaming right now. What the heck? Good stream. See you next time. Yeah, maybe we'll hit up Mr. Let's see. Mr. Tim Keyless. What's he doing? I've rated him a ton. We got gym leader Nathan doing a key cult commission brainstorming. We got Basic doing late night key chores. I haven't rated Basic in a while, and she was in here earlier, so I think we should probably hit Basic, huh? She was making fun of me earlier, so we should probably make fun of her. At least she knows who Heine is and Mikaze is. That was that. Dude, I was laughing so hard at that. I was laughing so hard. Why is my... Oh, there we go. Okay, now it's working. All right, so... What am I going to build next? I think we're going to do another... What's today? Monday? We're looking at either Wednesday or Thursday. I do have some pretty insane boards coming. My face hurt for a half hour. We're going to be doing the Kaze V2. Or, sorry. The Kaze prototype final. As well as the Dalco once the PCBs come in. I think that might be next week, though. I do have a bunch of other boards, like a Vulcan Pro and a couple others that I'm going to... probably put in the lineup here. So anyways, yeah, let's do that. Can I get a hole? Yeah, thank you guys for sticking around. Hopefully you like oh yeah. Hopefully you guys like the stream tonight, and then I'll see you either on Thursday, probably Wednesday or Thursday. So say hi to Basic for me. Peace.